Sorry, I didn't hear them. After...
For years, this has been the face of drug addiction in Canada. Vancouver's poverty-stricken downtown east side. In 1997, 400 people died of drug overdoses in this one square kilometer area alone, facing what was at the time described as an epidemic. Local governments, healthcare workers, and community activists successfully campaigned for a facility where addicts could inject drugs in a safe place while under supervision. In 2003, Insite was opened and has been going strong ever since.
We get between 600 and 1,000 visits per day. We're running at capacity. What we've been able to do during that time is build relationships, long-term relationships, with this really marginalized group of people that does not access healthcare.
Despite being the only facility of its kind, not only in the area, but in North America, needle sharing and public injections dropped dramatically. And according to respected medical journals, so did HIV and other infectious diseases, as well as overdoses. But the current conservative-led federal government wants to shut the site down, describing it as an abomination. Following a tough-on-drugs approach, the government is taking Insite to the Supreme Court of Canada in an attempt to close it for good. A move this addictions expert agrees with.
I think it's a terrible disaster and a sham. It should never have been put in place, but it's part of a huge, complex set of ideas, all of them wrong, all of them mistaken.
But drug users, like longtime addict Les Joe, who, according to records, has used Insite over 5,000 times since it opened 7 years ago, says it's attitudes like that which are the real mistake.
They don't know what it's all about. You know, we don't equal to them. We're junkies. Okay? But still, we're people.
Supporters of Insite say alleys like this is no place for people to inject drugs. The conservative-led government say people using drugs shouldn't be allowed to use anywhere at all, let alone at a publicly funded facility where medical health professionals work. Just who's right will be decided by the Supreme Court of Canada. Imtiaz Taib, Al Jazeera, Vancouver.